Another relationship that we have to understand is the one between fabrication cost and our chip area. Chips are manufactured by taking a silicon disk called a wafer and subjecting it to a number of steps. Each of these steps sort of prints some of the aspects of the circuitry that should be appearing on each processor. And there are a number of these steps. At the end of these steps, we take the wafer and we cut it up, and each one of these small squarish things is gonna be a chip. So this is a single chip. We take each chip and we put it in a package that has pins on it. So this is what you normally see as a chip. And then we test these chips. The ones that check out fine, we can sell. The ones that don't check out fine, we throw away because they don't work. It is important to understand that the manufacturing process up to cutting the chips up is all the same. The wafer, this disk, is about 12 inches in diameter. It costs thousands of dollars to put it through the manufacturing process, at which point we hope we get a number of working chips and very few non-working chips. But the size of the chip significantly affects the cost. Again, this entire process pretty much has a fixed cost. If we have more chips here because they're smaller, we will divide the wafer cost by the number of many good chips that we get, and our chips will be cheaper. If we have very large chips, we will get fewer of them when we test them especially, and we will divide this cost with fewer chips to get the cost. So it seems like the cost of a single chip is going to be linearly proportional to its size. But in fact, things are worse than that.